Well, hey there, Carrie here, and I am excited that you have our Disruptive Nutrition Planner Pad. And what I'm going to do right now is go over exactly how you can be using this. Now, there isn't one size fits all, but I just want to kind of give you our intentions and the big picture about how to use this so it is most effective. Now, before I dig into the actual planner, I want you to see, I like to see the forest before the trees. I usually like to talk about, if you're on a Google map and you're traveling, I often want to take a look at the big picture. I zoom out to see exactly where I am on the globe and then zoom in to start seeing closer and closer as to where I actually am. So we're going to take a 30,000 foot view in the Google map so that you can see really truly the purpose of what we're doing and why we're doing it. So I always talk about the fact that if you plan to actually succeed at what you're doing, you need to plan. So if you fail to do that, if you fail to plan, you actually plan to fail. And so somebody once told me years and years ago that how you spend your days translates to how you spend your weeks and your months and eventually your years. And we all know so well that the years go by fast. And you're like, gosh, what? I never did the things I said I wanted to do, right? And so let's really take a look at what that planning funnel is. When we think about our month, now we can even take a step back, right? And there's 12 months in a year. So if we're really not intentional about how we're spending our months, that year will go by so fast and we will have not accomplished or met certain goals that we've been wanting to do. So I want you to just to be thinking about this as a funnel, and we could go up into years and decades and all that, but we're not. We're going to just start with the month. So when we're really intentional about our month, that allows us to then be much more thoughtful about how we spend our weeks, because we can't have a successful month if we're not breaking that down into weeks. And then, of course, our weeks break down into days. And when we are very intentional around the hours in our days, it feeds up to productive weeks with purpose and intention, which feeds up to a month that will likely be more productive and more fulfilling than anything you've ever seen before. And when you have months that continuously push yourself, that continuously allow you to have that 1% progress, remember, success is really about applying consistently the basic fundamentals. And when we really think about how we want to spend our life, our years, we have to get down to the fact that it really matters on what we do for every hour of the day. Now, it is very important to know that I am not legalistic about this. However, I do budget my time. Time is one of the things we can never get back. We can always make more money. We cannot get back time, but yet there are people that seem to have so much more time in the day, don't they? We all have the same exact amount of time, but how we use it is really about how intentional we are. And that is the point of this planner pad. So before we even look at the planner pad, what I want you to do is to take out any monthly calendar that you have. They're everywhere. You can download them for free on the internet. And as you start to think about, and I don't care what day of the week you're or what day of the month you're doing this, take a look at your month. Put down in that monthly calendar the big events that you know that are happening. Put down in that monthly calendar somewhere on the side margin, what do you really want to have accomplished this month? When all is said and done, when this month is over, what do you want to say you have done? And I break that up into work and home. And I really just take a look at, I don't want another month to go by without doing X, Y, or Z. A perfect example of this, which might seem silly, but is actually very important to me, are my family albums. I had gotten into a habit of really being able to develop annual albums for my family. And as life got busier and as I got less intentional, I didn't keep up with it. So now I actually have this goal that each month I'm going to catch up with a family album. Now, that means I actually have to be able to be thoughtful around when that's going to happen. It's not going to magically occur because I want it to. It will only happen because I've been intentional about my hours at the bottom of that funnel. I know that in work, there might be projects that I want to have done, or at home. There might be rooms that I want to organize, or then a number of meals I want to be making for my family. I'm just very thoughtful at the end of a month, going into a new month, about really what do I want to accomplish. And then what I do after that is I take a big post-it note and I look at my month goals and the first week ahead, only 1 week. And I say, okay, out of these goals, what are the things that I want to accomplish this week? Now, if that is a monthly goal, I'm not going to accomplish it in a week, but what are the things that I need to do so that that goal could be met at the end of the month? And I literally just write it on a post-it note. These are the things that I know I need to do this week. And the post-it note is really important because I stick it on top of the Disruptive Nutrition Planner pad. And what I do is I take that post-it note and I look at what I want to have accomplished in the week. And that's when I lay out my days. So let's take a look at the planner pad. Okay. So at the very beginning of the week, I put my week up here, and there's a few different components of this. It's simple, but yet really, really nuanced. So if you have your post-it note, I usually stick my post-it note somewhere over on a day that it's not. And I just keep front and center. These are the things that I want to have done during the week. So if it's now a Sunday night, or even a Monday morning, I always talk about morning time, taking 5 to 10 minutes just to be able to look at your day and be intentional. How do I want to feel today? At the end of the day, how do I want to say I felt because of what I did? And just set your intention about what that is. Do you want to feel purposeful, balanced? Do you want to feel peaceful? You know, whatever it is, it's going to be different for you in different ways. And I work hard to be able to come up with new ways and new words. And then I look at that weekly goals, and these are the things I must get done today. Notice there's only 4 bullets. So these are the big things that I know are going to take me closer to those weekly and then monthly goals. Okay. This isn't my entire to-do list, right? I actually will use the back of this page to brainstorm tiny little 5-minute things that I know I can't forget. Or I have a lot of people that use Google Tasks, right? That's your overall kind of all the brain dump of the things I have to do. But these are the 4 things I have to do today to get me closer to those weekly goals, because that's what really matters. Now, then we time block. So I take my to-do list and I take my must-do list, as well as my appointments, my meetings, all of that. And I actually time block them into my day. I take a pen and I write them down. When am I working out? When am I doing the bullet point 1? How much time do I need for that? Now, remember, maybe your weekly goal, you're just going to do a few 15-minute things that are eventually going to get you there. You're going to actually be really intentional about your time. I want you to think about this like a budget. If you had $100 and you had to put $5, $10, $15 in certain categories till you got to your $100, that's how you would do a budget. Well, this is no different. You have all of these hours. What are you going to do with them? And when you are really intentional with your time, it's amazing. A, how much more time we have, but B, how we realize once we do this, well, gosh, I can't get done all the things that I want to get done. And so we get to redefine our definition of success. When you see that it's physically impossible to do all the things, especially as busy working women, well, then maybe you need to recognize that I'm not going to get all that done today. And that's why we have it at a glance, right? You have your whole week ahead. So sometimes if I know I have a big project or a big task that I want to do, at the beginning of the week, I'll put it down for 3, 4, 5 days and make sure that I have that planned out in my week. But for the most part, I go day by day. And I make sure that on my Monday night, for example, I plan out my Tuesday. Some people like to do it in the morning. I actually fold the paper over, so I'm only really seeing that day and the day before. Anything I didn't get done, I give myself grace. I circle. And then I decide if it's really important, if I'm going to do it on the next day. I do plan out my dinners in advance. So on Sundays, I go into our recipe vault in the Disruptive Nutrition Recipe Vault, but also you can just be, you know, going to your go-to dinners if you're not part of that, and just writing out what your dinner plan is, right? So that you have that ready to go. I then time block when I'm going to be preparing my dinner. Now, my family also shares in the dinner responsibility. So if my husband's going to cook the dinner that night, I'll put his name next to this. So I know what the plan is. I used to say, gosh, these kids and my husband and my family, they just need to eat all the time. And dinner used to just sneak up on me. No longer does. When I have my dinner planned for the week, I make my grocery list and we grocery shop on Sundays and we have everything ready. I have my workout planned in here, but it feels good to check it off. And then you can write what workout you did that day. We really suggest that you're strength training at least 2 to 3 times a week. And this way you can even put your little plan in advance here. And then at the very end of the day, what I want you to do is just reflect on your day. How did you want to feel and how did you feel? No guilt if you didn't get done the things that you didn't get done. But at the end of the day, did you feel balanced or did you feel chaotic? And it gives you a second to be able to really think through what it is that happened and why you got into that chaotic place. Self-awareness is absolute health. And the more aware we are, the better we can be. Now take a look at the end of the week. Saturdays and Sundays are a little bit more free flowing, but I still block out my times of things I know I want to get done and what I want to get done for the weekend. So I actually use this for my weekend of the must do's that I want to do. And there's just extra little piece here on Sundays that says, are you prepared for next week? Now it doesn't have to be on Sunday, but are you prepared for next week? And there is something gratifying about checking that off. And then I keep this, I rip it off and then I hold onto it. I actually fold it in half and right over here on the side, I put the week that it was. I fold it in half, put week of, and then whatever that week is. And then I can go back and look at different things that I did. It's a reminder of how I was feeling and allows me kind of a little bit of a documentation without doing a ton of journaling or any of that. So I can remind myself of just how incredible I am, right? Because just taking the time to plan this out is such an act of self-care, not just for you, but for your entire family. So I hope that using this is beneficial, productive, and meaningful for you, that this tutorial helps you see this in a way that allows you to be really effective and productive. I would love to be able to get your insight and your thoughts and your reflections on how you're using. Feel free to reply back to my email. Feel free to get us on Facebook and put your comments down and share in our free Facebook group, Diet Disruptor Squad, pictures of you using this and what it's doing for you and your life. We can't wait to be able to connect with you and see what a difference this makes. Thanks.